Hello. This is going to be a little video on a military dagger that I bought myself to add to my collection of stuff for military-based gear. This is the Fairbairn-Sykes fighting knife, and it's actually a dagger because the edges are sharpened, supposed to be sharpened. I've sharpened mine because it came almost as bad as a butter knife. Not quite as bad as butter knife, but yeah, it was blunt as hell. So yeah, if you end up buying one of these, you may have to do some sharpening as I've done. But the main secret of this weapon is the needle point tip. Now, I don't know if you're going to be able to see this. I'm going to try and get it to focus. Come on. Right. That right there is an absolute needle point. It does not take hardly any force to go through a plastic bottle of drink. So I've sharpened this myself, and I've had to re-blue the outer finish on it because I did knock off some of the black finish on the blade. These were being made around World War II kind of era. This is a modern one of the third pattern. They went through the first one, the second one, and the third one is because they needed a more easy to produce, mass-produced version because the war, you know. So this is the third pattern, but just a modern made one. So you've got your sharpened edges and the sharp point. And so this was a thrusting weapon. And the reason for the length is to get through outer layers of clothing while still getting into the body to get to the vital squishy bits, as someone described. It comes with a leather sheath like this one, which I kind of like. It seems relatively thick leather, but the problem is the retainer. It's just a little piece of elastic, and it's not very tight. It's kind of droopy, and if you were to like use these flaps to sew it into clothing or something, it kind of falls, and I don't think that's a good thing. So for anyone that actually in the military who would want to carry one of these, I would recommend you keep it upright. You do have a belt loop right here, but at least if it's upright, it's not going to fall. However, because a lot of my little shelf here for Militaria, I'll just give you a quick view of that, is either British or American camo, which I think this is MTP, but this, I have a feeling this might not be MTP, this might be multicam. This is an aftermarket sheath that I bought for the Fairbairn-Sykes knife. Both arrived today. You've got MOLLE attachments here, and a leg strap so that you can kind of keep it firm to your leg, so when you draw the knife out, it's not going to kind of flip up on you, because that would be really inconvenient. So I just like threaded it on the outside, made a little twist up here so that I can hang it from my shelf. It's got some nice rigidity to it. It has a liner on it, so it's kind of rigid. It can be awkward to put it in, but I don't know if that's because of the design or just whether this one is new that's the problem. But you just slide it in. I don't know if I just cut something or not. And you've got Velcro instead of the flimsy elastic. And you've got two of these. So you could actually mount this upside down somewhere, because the most it's going to kind of droop down is about that much, which is not much. So there's a lot less chance that something's going to get cut on the exposed cutting edges. But you do have MOLLE attachments on the back. Yeah, so I really like that, and that's gonna go right there, just like that. Let's see if I can get you a view on that. There you go, right there. That's where it's going to live. But yeah, I really like this. It's a little piece of history. This is a modern one, but they did have these in World War II, just they look slightly different. They had a different grip on the handle, and the blade had some minor differences, and the first edition had like a square bit with like engraving on. But yeah, these have been used throughout history, including to the present day, by the way. If you look at news articles, you'll find a news article from 2019 where a Royal Marine used one of these to kill an ISIS terrorist because he was attacked, and he instinctively went for his World War II one. I don't know if it was from World War II or if it was just one of these and the news people said it was World War II. But whether it was a modern one or an actual old one, it was one of these knives, and it saved his life and rid the world of a terrorist. So they may be old, but it's a very efficient design. So that's why there's a lot of military groups around the world still issue these to their people. And it was typically held like this, and held like horizontally, and they would swish it backwards and forwards and lunge, and they had more elaborate techniques for using it, which I won't go into. You can always look that up. But this is really nice. I've been wanting one of these for a long time, but I've been so busy with other things and buying other stuff that when I thought about it, I had to get it, because once I've got it, I've got it. So now it's paid for, I have it in my hand. Now I don't have to worry about it. I finally have one in my collection. So there you go. This isn't really, it doesn't have much in terms of utility. You can't, whereas the K-bar, wherever I put it down there, you can't see that, it's off camera, but the K-bar, you can use that as a general knife. It's very useful, and I've used it for chopping small limbs of trees, all sorts. Whereas this, it really is either a collector's piece or a weapon of death. There isn't, it's like, you know, that's pretty much all there is to it. So, I suppose you could use it as a letter opener, but I wouldn't recommend it. You might cut your letter. But there you go. That's the Fairbairn-Sykes fighting knife, or Royal Commando Dagger. Please like, subscribe, and I'll see you on whatever the next video happens to be about. Thank you.